In March 1992, Yugoslavia was already breaking up along ethnic lines when Bosnia-Herzegovina declared independence. Bosnia Serbs, Orthodox Christians, wanted their own state, and they went to war for it. Their principal victims were Bosnia's Muslim population. The Bosnian Serbs attacked parts of the capital, Sarajevo, to force the Muslims out. The UN had banned arms sales to the region to reduce the violence. This left the Muslims practically defenseless against the Bosnian Serbs, who had heavy weapons from their patrons in Yugoslavia.
Yeah, and they're echoing over the front line in Mostar, the most vicious theater of war in Bosnia-Herzegovina. Since May, Bosnian Croats, aided and abetted by the Croatian government, have been laying siege to about 60,000 people in East Mostar. Almost all of them are Muslims, and they're fighting back hard. A local cameraman called Miralem Smail Hodžić documented the Croats' attempts to destroy it. He took these pictures. He's dead now, killed by a mortar a month or so ago. Everything from the explosion to this had taken about 10 minutes. The hospital was ready for the next casualties.
This morning we were trying to repair our wall. It was destroyed by a mortar. He stepped out to find out what the time was and to get some water so that I could wash our clothes. That's when it happened.
The more the doctors see, the more it hurts. They said they tried not to let it show.
Even to bring food to starving people, because they had to negotiate with Bosnian Serb militias.
They should have shot their way in if necessary. And had they shot their way in, the Serb...
On July 11, 1995, 5 days after Saliha Osmanovic's son was killed, the Muslim town of Srebrenica in eastern Bosnia fell to the Bosnian Serb army. The world's first United Nations safe area became the site of the worst massacre in Europe since World War II. Along with hundreds of other widows and survivors of Srebrenica, she's going back for the first time into Serbian territory. The Dutch soldiers were responsible for watching over the first United Nations safe area. But between the 11th and the 14th of July, 1995, faced with 25,000 desperate refugees, the UN peacekeepers and the international community stood by as men were separated from women by the Bosnian Serb army. In the old salt mines under the Muslim town of Tuzla, they still store more than 1,000 nameless bodies from Srebrenica. Coming to this awful place, it's impossible to escape the reality that this happened in Europe at the end of the 20th century.
The other punishment is that the Western community, or if you like, we can say the world community, or the world conscience, or European community, giving us some hopes that they will help us as victims. They betrayed us, and we believed them. And now they are betraying themselves. And they don't want to help us, but they don't allow us ourselves to help ourselves. Because it is illogical, it is immoral, it is a cry. We don't ask Europe or Christians to come and to save the Muslims. We ask only one simple thing. Please, give us our right. And our right is to defend ourselves. And you don't do.
Sarajevo was described by news organizations as a siege.
It gets no better at night. 500 Muslims had just been robbed and thrown out of their homes in West Mostar by the Croats. They had to cross the river Neretva to get to comparative safety on a bridge made of rope and planks.
Every 15 minutes, another truckload of refugees is dropped off at the Tuzla airbase. After registration, they will join the close to 6,000 people already settled in tents next to the runway.
The world saw television images of sniper and shellfire raining down on the city's mainly Muslim population from the steep surrounding hills. In 1995, 43 people were killed and dozens injured when a mortar shell hit people queuing for bread. A year earlier, 68 people were killed and scores wounded at this market. The memories of those events are still fresh in people's minds, and the verdict in The Hague gives them little comfort. Esan Klinic witnessed both massacres.
Of course it's stressful. Those images come back every now and then.
The brutal legacy of Radovan Karadzic, the Bosnian capital, Sarajevo, under siege. The nationalist fury of the Bosnian Serb army unleashed on a captive civilian population and directed from the hills above by this man. The one-time poet and psychiatrist Radovan Karadzic took to politics as the old Yugoslavia was falling apart. He furiously resisted Bosnian independence and resorted to war when he couldn't get his own way.
He is, of course, a psychiatrist. That is one of the things that is, I find, as a qualified doctor.